Miss Nelson is missing. The room and the kids in room 207 were misbehaving again. Spitballs stuck to the ceiling. Paper planes whistled through the air. They were the worst behaved class in the whole school. "Now settle down," said Miss Nelson in a sweet voice, but the class would not settle down. They whispered and giggled. They squirmed and made faces. They were even rude during story hour, and they always refused to do their lessons. "Something will have to be done," said Miss Nelson. The next morning, Miss Nelson did not come to school. "Whoa," yelled the kids. "Now we can really act up." They began to make more spitballs and paper planes. "Today, let's be just terrible," they said. "Not so fast," hissed an unpleasant voice. A woman in an ugly black dress stood before them. "I am your new teacher, Miss Viola Squam." And she wrapped the desk with her ruler. "Where is Miss Nelson?" asked the kids. "Never mind that," snapped Miss Squam. "Open those arithmetic books." Miss Nelson's kids did as they were told. They could see that Miss Squam was a real witch. She meant business. Right away, she put them to work, and she loaded them done with homework. "When, well, have no story time today," said Miss Nelson Squam. "Miss Squam." "Keep your mouth shut," said Miss Squam. "Sit perfectly still," said Miss Squam. "And if you misbehave, you'll be sorry," said Miss Squam. The kids in room 207 had never worked so hard. Days went by, and there were no sign of Miss Nelson. The kids missed Miss Nelson. "Maybe we should try to find her," they said. Some of them went to the police. Detective Nick Snom said was assigned to the case. He listened to the story. He scratched his chin. He said, "I think Miss Nelson is missing." Detective Nick Smong was not gonna be much help. Other kids went to Miss Nelson's house. The shades were tightly drawn, and no one answered the door. In fact, the only person that they did see was the wicked Miss Viola Squam coming up the street. "If she sees us, she'll give us more homework." They got away in time. "Maybe something terrible happened to Miss Nelson. Maybe she was clawed by a shark," said one of the kids, but that didn't seem likely. "Maybe Miss Nelson went to Mars," said another kid, but that didn't seem likely either. "I know," explained the one know-it-all. "Maybe Miss Nelson's claw was carried off by a swarm of angry butterflies, but that was the least likely of all." The kids in room 207 became very discouraged. It seemed that Miss Nelson was never coming back, and they would be stuck with Miss Viola Squam forever. They heard footsteps in the hall. "Here comes the witch," they whispered. "Hello, children," said a sweet voice. It was Miss Nelson. "Did you miss me?" she asked. "We certainly did," they cried. "Where were you?" "That's my little secret," said Miss Nelson. "How about story hour?" "Oh yes," cried the kids. Miss Nelson noticed during story hour, no one was rude or silly. "What brought all this lovely change?" she asked. "That's her little secret," said the kids. Back home, Miss Nelson took off her coat and hanged it up in her closet, right next to an ugly black dress. When it was time for bed, she sang a little song. "I will never tell," she said to herself with a smile. P.S. Detective McSnob is now on a new case. He is now looking for Miss Viola Scram. Bye.